Hey guys, this is Kyle. Today I'm going to be showing off Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified for the PlayStation Vita. I believe it just came out today in the West. Obviously I'm in Japan, but I have found an import shop around here that actually got the game. I wasn't originally planning on picking it up, but after hearing some decent things about it, I figured why not, we'll give it a shot. So here it is. I'm playing online right now. 4v4 is the max for online, which was a little bit disappointing to some people, but actually it runs pretty smooth so far. I've been pretty happy with it. So yeah, I don't know too much about the game so far. I plugged it in and got online right away. I've been playing online for the last little while, but I figured that I would show off, you know, the game overall. You guys can see how it works online. Didn't quite work out for me. This is one of the bigger maps here. Obviously with 4v4, it's kind of a smaller loadout. So a lot of these maps in the game are actually quite a bit smaller than this. I think this is the biggest one I've played so far. But obviously it is nice to have some variety. You can see the game looks decent. I'm not going to say it looks great. It is a somewhat sub-native res. I can't really tell exactly what resolution it runs at yet, but it's not perfect, but no, I think it gets the job done all right. Wow. So you can see here when I die, you have the choice to immediately respawn. You can change your class mid-respawn. I haven't messed with the class very much yet. You have some default classes that you can pick from when you start up online. You also earn different things, obviously, as you level up, and you can create a custom class to use online. I'll show that off in just a minute once this match is over. Got taken out from behind there. So if you press select, like in most games, you can see the list there of kills and deaths. Obviously, it's usually not the smartest thing to pull up in the middle of the round, but there you go. I'm not doing so hot this round. Looks like I'm sitting at 9 kills and 17 deaths. I believe noob is the word you are looking for. Probably go catch up with my team and group together with them. There we go. So you can see we lost there at the end. I ended up with 11 kills, 18 deaths, score of 1140, a couple of assists there. So then it goes ahead and saves your profile here. So you know, it shows your experience there. So I'm level 8 right now. I'm a specialist 2, working on level 9. Get your total EXP readout there. So here you can go ahead, basically keeps you in the same game as you'll see there. Me and a couple other dudes here. It looks like most of them just left, so we'll end up just automatically searching for, you know, the remaining players. So from here we have options, obviously. Stick layout, inversion, sensitivity, which I've been playing with a little bit. Sprint always on, whether you want to use a button or just have it always on when you hold up on the analog stick. And subtitles. And here's that create a class, which I was talking about before. So if we pop into create a class, you can create up to 5 custom classes with whatever abilities and stuff like that you want there. Again, I haven't messed with it too much yet. I just hopped right into deathmatch. So if it doesn't fill in the remaining slots, it'll actually just go ahead and start the match with what we've got here. So let's see what ends up happening here. Because it looks like there were only 3 of us. Decent little load here for each of the levels. A little bit longer than I would have liked, but it's not horrible. And then it syncs up with everyone once the load's done. So you choose from your preset classes in here. Obviously, if you've created custom, you can pick them from there. Team Deathmatch. Team Deathmatch, it looks like I might be the only one on my team, and I am. So this is going to be 1 versus 2. Get ready to laugh. But we'll see what we can do. Still don't quite know all the controls. You can use X to jump. Suppose they're probably both together somewhere hanging out. Got me from behind. So it looks like I've somehow now gained a partner, and their team is now down to just 1. Not really sure how that happened, but there you go. One thing I am curious about is whether or not custom soundtracks work. Check that out after this game. Yeah, I'm not sure if you guys just witnessed that or not. It looked like that dude just pulled a Jesus on air and walked across the map. Don't know what's up with my partner here either. Okay. Go ahead and quit out of this one. This one seems a little jacked up. We'll test custom soundtracks out and see if we can't get any other dudes to walk on the air like Jesus. Get some music going. So far, so good. It keeps playing in the game. Why don't we look for a free-for-all this time? Got into one quite quickly there on Rocket. And the music's playing, so it looks like custom soundtracks might be good to go, which is pretty cool. Very few, but some games do block them, for those of you who don't know. In we go. Yeah, it looks like custom soundtracks, no problem. It's always nice. Oh yeah, free for all this time. Might not be my forte, to be honest. As if you couldn't tell, faithful viewer. There's one issue I've had so far, is trying to go for my grenade, I hit my knife. I'll have to see if I can fix that somehow. Might just have to get used to it. Alright! This is going very well. I'm also getting my ass kicked. I got him in the end. You guys saw that one. Damn, so not just kill streaks, we have to have death streaks. Game gonna remind me of that. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, shit. Spawned in an opportune location, if you will. There we go. Doing a little bit better. So there we go. That's the end of the free-for-all there. You can see I did pathetically bad. I'm not really sure why it put me ahead of that guy, because I died way more than that guy. See if I do this. Yeah, custom soundtracks work nicely, so that's cool. End up with a very minuscule amount of experience there. Let's go ahead and pop into one more team game and see how that goes. Not party. There we go, popped into a full game there. Mostly full anyway. Oh, and down here you can see it gives you the option of a couple places you can vote on these. So if I want Nuke House, just tap Nuke House. It should give me the option to vote for it. It's not. I don't know why. Ah, looks like voting's closed, so... But we got Nuke House anyway. I like how that works. Really like games like this that support custom soundtracks. Let's stick with this, see how it goes. Looks like we got 3-on-3. Don't worry, everyone, it was just a plant. Alright, so circle ducks, that's nice to know. Always very helpful. Another grenade fail there. Oh, that would be my my teammate there. Ouch. Still doing pretty poorly here. Wow. At least I got him with the knife. Whoops. Still a happy ending. There you go, looks like they beat us. But anyway, once again, you can see there, it saves up, you get your EXP from the match. And obviously that unlocks different things for your class. Anyway, that is it for now anyway. A little rough around the edges, especially my playing, as you can see. Besides that Air Jesus guy though, not too bad on the glitchy side. And yeah, lag doesn't seem too bad, especially playing from Japan. Anyway, I will keep playing this and maybe get a little bit better. Probably not. And yeah, check back with you guys. But anyway, thanks for watching.